on the road again for the last time with Uber, 2% battery, but we're all packed up into the tuk-tuk.
Shall I park?
Oh.
Other than that, no damage. Well, we're really careful with it. But yeah, obviously you're going to inspect it. Yeah, sad. It's sad to say goodbye.
I'll take
again. Oh, yeah, for sure. I think maybe rent a car.
Uber is back.
It's back. It's back home.
We should probably let them know that we're here, I guess. She's going.
Need masks. 1% battery. Quite sad actually. Really nice TV. Really recommend it. We are going to get a little tuk-tuk. We've got a little bit. We're just trying to figure out. We've now got pay for a tuk-tuk. We'll get to our hotel. Yeah. Uber is home.
Looking sound,
so are we. Yesterday at dinner, the Italian, the guy, I kept thinking the guy looked back and he was like, and you saw what I was doing, he's like laughing.
So this is Sea Joy, where we have our breakfast every morning. But yeah, fruit juice, coffee, toast and butter. And she gives us a discount because we don't have all the other extra bits. Basic breakfast here because we can't eat rice and dal and that every morning. It's too much. Well, Siemens actually, our breakfast seems to be around lunchtime and probably good. Rupert's on his last.
That cigarette, until I get to my rolling backy, being like, especially you ordered in for me.
And we've got three more mornings in Negombo. And then we fly to Thailand.
Well, I do.
I do.
I just be hoping Kelly gets on the plane, otherwise you'd meet me out there.
You have to apply for a Thai pass. We did it the first time, we got rejected, so I changed what needed to be changed for both of us. We have the exact same paperwork. Rupert's got accepted and mine got rejected. Which is very frustrating, it seems I did both of them.
I need the same document.
And then I did it again. And I got rejected. I got a rejection email and an acceptance email at the same time. An acceptance email comes with a QR code that you need for Thailand. So it's all done through a system, so there's obviously a fault in the system, but I have an acceptance email and a QR code, so.
Now it looks like real tourists. So no. Why are we going up?
Roof.
Oh shit.
So we're at the Regal Hotel. They've got a rooftop bar out on the beach, so we thought we'd try and come in and come up and watch the sunset from up there, because it's going to be really pretty.
Hopefully. It looked nice yesterday.
Yeah, it's a really good sunset yesterday.
There's glass and like, and it makes my legs feel a little bit weird. And also, if I look at you, the sea is like right down there.
Rupert's talking about his vertigo. But
I'm all right.
We are up at the rooftop bar to watch the sunset. I wish we could get in the pool. In Negombo, the sunset, all the crows fly past. I need to actually look why they do this, because it's insane, there's thousands. This is where we're going to be coming for the next 5 days. Sunset. It's beautiful. Beautiful sunset. Beautiful boyfriend.
That's me.
Nice drink.
And a beautiful girl.
We've had a very lazy few days. Slept in late every day. We've been having breakfast at lunchtime. At the same place every morning, because they're nice people and we get what we need. We did go for a drink today with, how do you pronounce his name?
A friend.
When we were back in Negombo a couple of days ago, we went to Toro for food because we love Toro. And our waiter was really lovely. We had a really good chat with him, and he wanted to hang out sometime. So we met up with him today and had a drink at his friend's new restaurant called Lava, which is just up the road here. It was really lovely. It was nice to hang out with someone different. Yeah, we've seen many people for a few days in Negombo, and very busy. But yeah, it's been really nice. The days go very quick. Very, very quick. I have no idea if my head was even in that one. Not you. Oh, oh, oh. 5 more sleeps and we're on a plane to Thailand. Hopefully, after a negative test on Thursday. Yeah, hopefully a negative positive test on Thursday. Having a great time. Exciting. But yes. You bring back memories, bring back you.
Margarita pizzas. They're not folded in half if you look at it closely. So you can make your own.
Yeah, like you said, basically a pizza folded in half. But that is what calzone is, and I love a calzone.
We will show you the pizza when it comes.
And a very expensive Coca-Cola.
Yeah. We've both got a giant pizza.
Rupert ate one extra slice. Rupert ate all of his.
smaller slice than mine. He's going to take this back for midnight snack. But whole town, blackouts, power cut. Using the car lights to find where we're going. The funny thing is you have to switch between walking in the road in the pitch black or the pass, because the pass have gigantic holes in. So the road is safer on most occasions. A couple of shops have lights, but this one has a generator. See, Joy's doing fine, whatever else is in the darkness.
She looked me both ways,
and then back into the darkness. Yeah, you can tell the restaurants that make good money because they have their own generators. The big fancy hotels have all their lights. And it's actually scary. It's like I get the purge sort of feeling. And we will go back to our hotel now, which will also be completely pitch black throughout the whole building. No fan, no anything. Did you say hi, princess?
Huh?
I thought the guy on the bike said hi, princess. But yeah.
The guy on the bike said
hi, princess.
I'm saying something like that, or my car, or something.
Hey, we're back at the hotel. As you can see, you can't see us. Ladies in there with a candle, but yeah, that's it for us, guys. Good night.
Sri Lankan, I think it's like an Asian volleyball championship.
Come on, Sri Lanka!
On the road again.
Let's go to Bangkok.
And we didn't know what to expect of Sri Lanka, actually. Absolutely no idea, but it was incredible. And we've loved the last 2 months.
Yeah, Sri Lanka was a big surprise, a hidden gem. Like, there's not many, there are videos on YouTube about it, but nowhere near as many as you'd get in like Thailand and Vietnam and places like that, the more, you know, the more popular backpacking destinations. But Sri Lanka's got to be up there as far as we're concerned. I mean, I've been to a few countries already, but Sri Lanka was just, this, it's got everything. Whether you want beaches or you want mountains or countryside or whatever, it's got it.
Good food, good people,
everything. It's got something for everybody. If you've got money, if you haven't got money. And yeah, it was absolutely stunning. Definitely be going back. Definitely go back. And the people there are genuine, and they always make you feel welcome. And it was just one of those places where you felt safe as well. I don't think we ever felt unsafe at all, really, did we? Not once during the whole trip. Maybe on the roads a few times, but that again.
Yeah, the buses in Sri Lanka are nuts.
But that's not your typical day, like walking around, even through the busiest parts of Colombo and that. Feels safe and secure. It's got so much beauty, and yeah, I think it was brilliant. That's why we stayed another month. That's why we extended it. It's just, there's so much to offer.
We actually did an intro tour in Bali now 3 years ago, and they were starting to do tours in Sri Lanka, and we booked an open ticket with them 3 years ago in Bali, and then COVID happened, so obviously we didn't go, and then we decided to go traveling properly, just the two of us, and go all out. So we decided to do Sri Lanka on our own and
rent the tuk-tuk,
yeah, Uber. And that was honestly the best decision.
Yeah, tuktukrental.com is who we used. Very fair price, much cheaper than buying, you know, getting Ubers and taxis and buses and stuff if you add it all up. And it gives you the freedom to literally go where you want. It's safe than motorbikes, you're covered from the sun, protected from the sun during the day, you're not exposed.
And then machines, we drove down on it, unsurfaced roads, mountains. We drove for 5, 6, 7, 8 hours, and we didn't have trouble with our tuk-tuk once. They're impressive little things. I can see why they're used, because they're so efficient
and so versatile.
Yeah, my favorite place in Sri Lanka is Ella. I just love, as soon as we got there, I love the feeling of the little town. It had a nice amount of people, lots of little shops, lots of little restaurants, middle of the mountains. It was just beautiful, and I loved it from the second we arrived. So much that we went back twice, and I'm so glad we went back the second time.
But I don't know, see, I really like the, there's so many different things. Driving the tuk-tuk from Trincomalee to Aragon Bay was absolutely breathtaking. I think there's times during that drive. Yeah, there are times during that drive where you're just gobsmacked about the natural beauty of the place. But yeah, I mean, Nuwara Eliya, driving from that to Kandy, that also was beautiful. Beach-wise, I liked the place we stayed at. The beach, the home, the hostel. Where was that? I can never remember the name of the beach.
Where?
One of the first places we stayed at, where we met the Dutch couple.
Oh, Barra Beach.
Barra Beach. That was just, yeah, that was hostel. Awesome little place. Yeah. That was really Gala
was
nice.
That was the best sunsets, I think. There's one of the top three sunsets we've seen our entire trip. Oh, it was so good. So nice. But yeah, we've loved Sri Lanka, and
you've leased the turtles.
Yes, in Bentoda. We went to a turtle sanctuary and they invited us back to help release the baby turtles. That was perfection. That was literally the highlight of the trip for me. And then we love a sunset, so we set the turtles free at sunset. If anyone gets the opportunity to do that.
Yeah, it's definitely a magical moment doing something like that.
Oh, it's so nice. It's so nice.
There's so many different things. There's so many different experiences.
I hope Tina and Turner and Thomas and...
Yeah.
Terry?
Yeah.
Are doing well. They're probably quite big now.
I don't know. I don't know about how big they would be, but hopefully they're still alive. Living it. But,
yeah, if you haven't been, go to Sri Lanka. The food, I'm a fussy eater, I'm really bad at eating, but I'm obsessed with dal and vegetarian curries, and we need to go home and
We seriously need to learn how to cook some Asian food. The food in Sri Lanka is amazing. There wasn't one meal I had I didn't like. There wasn't one thing I ate I didn't like, other than in Hikkaduwa, I think it was. But that was just because of the way they cooked it. It wasn't the food, it was just more like the place.
It wasn't done like everyone else done, like traditionally cooked.
I don't know what it was. I mean, I don't know what it was, it doesn't matter. But that was the only bad meal I had. But that wasn't down to the flavourings, it was just the way it was cooked. Because I'd had those flavours before, and I think I'd had that meal before, and it was fantastic. So I know it just wasn't being done right. But that was once out of, you know, 2 months worth of eating food. And there was flavours I never tasted before, and combinations I never had before. Yeah, and the food really blew my mind. Really blew my mind.
So, if you're watching this, thank you for watching our videos from Sri Lanka.
Did not expect so many subscribers, that's for sure.
Yeah, no, we were just doing it because Rupert got into filming. We got the drone and camera before we came, and Rupert really got into making videos and everything with that. So we're like, oh, we'll make videos as we go along.
It's a document for ourselves and family, because we didn't think anyone else would be interested in watching it. It's more so that we can look back on it in years' time, you know, and show our kids, and remind ourselves of what an adventure we took. And the best place to do that is put it on YouTube, because then my mum can watch it live, and your mum can watch it, and friends and family can watch it. But the fact we've had so many subscribers, you know, people we don't know, is amazing, and we are really grateful.
Yeah,
and
it's
nice to know that people are watching it, and following it. Following us. A bit more pressure on making the videos, I must admit. Now I'm making them thinking, oh God, people are actually watching these.
But yeah, goodbye Sri Lanka.
Yeah, goodbye Sri Lanka.
And then,
we'll definitely be recommending you. Yeah, and hello Thailand.